Ready? I pinned myself. You can like make sure that I'm the focus, but I kind of like to see the grid so I can kind of get glimpses of y'all and see if you're still with me or if you've gone off to get like a cup of coffee or something. So if you have ankle weights today, grab them. We're going to start with them. If you don't have them, I promise you this will be tough enough without. I promise. I even like kind of debated like, do I even want to do this with ankle weights on? But I'm going to do it. All right, one leg out to the side. It's my right leg. It doesn't matter which one. Little bend in the standing leg. Anytime you bend your standing leg, your butt goes back. I'm Maeve. Helps if I introduce myself. If you're new to me, everything is open to change, to modification, to whatever you need it to be. The most important thing is that you stay with me and you keep moving in some way, whether it's your version of the exercise or my version of the exercise. I just want you moving until we're holding. And then I want you holding. You know what I'm trying to say, right? Again. So standing leg, that hip is stabilizing like crazy while this leg is moving. Yes. Yes. Good, now hold it up. We're gonna cross. Try to float this leg as much as you can. Yes. Beautiful. If you lose your balance like I just did, you just tap down and you re-find it. So good. So good, so good, so good. Two more. Hold it out. Side. Beautiful. I'm a big fan of learning to access and utilize abdominals while standing. Because that's when we use them a lot, right? But we often lie down just to work abs. Which translates, but it's important to be able to access here. Again. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Four more. Come through center squat. This is like just kind of like shake it out. Yes, yes. Ground down into those feet. I say this a lot and I hope it clicks, but own the ground under you. So like claim the ground. Don't let the ground pull you down. You stamp down, like put your imprint down. Can you get a little deeper? Yes, 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 yes. Come on. Bring it up. Second side. It's my left leg, whatever it is for you. Lift. If you haven't noticed, I like to like handle myself. Like hand on my belly, hand on my butt, because I want to feel what I'm working. And also that sends signals to my brain like that's what I want to be working. No Macarena. Yes. 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 We're not out. We did like 1,000,005 on the first side. Come on. More, 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 more. Don't stop. 8, 7, 3, 2. We're going to cross it. Yes. Oh, my goodness. So good. So good. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Oh, we got that side bend right here. Come on, come on, come on. Squat. So good. A little deeper if you can. Yes. Bring your hands down, step it back. Plank. All right, actually, let's bring your knees down because this is going to be really important for what we're about to do. Bring your knees down. Push the ground away. Think about doing cat's pose in your upper back and pulling your belly in like crazy. Keep that. Either stay on your knees or lift your knees up, but keep that. Pull your gaze past your fingers. We're going to alternate hip extension. That means when your leg goes up, your booty is contracted. We're not arching the low back. So nice hard draw up of the front ribs in the belly. Broadness across the back, across the chest. Right leg only. Right leg only. Bring it down, left leg only. Right again, right again, right again. Left again, let's go. Good, now watch. You're gonna step out to the right, foot, foot, in, to the left, out, out, shoulders stay put. So you're creating a side bend. You need to use your forearms because your wrists are not happy here, do that. That's the kind of stuff I want you to figure out on your own, though. Take care of yourself. Problem solve. One more, one more. Woo! Bring it down. Stretch back. Beautiful. Okay. I'm going to put a dumbbell end to end. I think we did this recently. And I'm going to line it up with my hip. You could use a yoga block. You're gonna take your knee above that. This is your end point. We're not gonna actually touch though. Push the ground away. Lift. I said we're not gonna touch and then I touched every single rep I did. I gotta call myself out. So the emphasis is on the up. Four more. Four. Three. Two. Hold it up. Left forearm comes down. We're going to extend this right leg back. Tap the elbow. Looking for that full extension. Push. Reach your toes away. When that knee comes in, you get a little crunch. Yes. Hold this next one up. Hold it up. Hold it up. Good. Get light in your right hand here. Or whatever. I didn't give you right and left, did I? Whatever this hand is, I want you to get light in it. Maybe even take the hand up. Maybe reach it up. We're going to pulse the leg up. It becomes a balancing act here. Push that forearm down. Yes. Leg longer, spine longer. Be so big in your body, please. Yes! Eight more, come eight. Four, three, two, one. Oh my goodness, knee in, stretch back. I swear I'm never gonna learn. I always start with my right side, which is like my stronger side. All right, second side. For me, it's left. This is going to be tough. I can't guarantee that you're not going to hear a lot of grunting, and I can't guarantee what words are going to come out of my mouth here on this second side. Bring that knee up. I will do my best to be a lady. Lift. Oh, easy breezy, right? The first four, I'm like, I got this. So we've just limited our range of motion. Again. Good, hold it up. Opposite arm to that leg that's lifting. Extend it back. Oh my goodness. Bring it in. Push. You have all the time you need to find that full extension. Do not feel rushed. Feel that stability in the hip of the bottom leg, right? It's working like crazy to hold you strong here. Feel that crunch, oopsies, when you bring your knee in. Keep the current. Two more, please. Get light in these fingertips. So now the bottom hip, push it toward the opposite side so you're really stabilizing. Like if you were in yoga, it'd be like a half moon, yeah? Maybe lift up, up with that leg. If you need to put the hand down for stability, don't let that be a factor. Yes. Longer leg. Yeah. Ha!
time.
Yes, come on. 4, 3, 2, beautiful. Oh my goodness, come on your backs. 2 dumbbells if you have them. I'm gonna keep my ankle weights on for a wee bit longer. My weights are not that heavy. I actually wish they were a little bit lighter. They're 8 pounds. I could use a 5 right now, if that gives you any indicator. The arms are just gonna stay out. Bent elbows. I have to situate myself with the wall here. Shoulders curl up. One leg draws in. Other knee draws in. Full extension.
Golden siren. Underexpose me.
All the weights are optional.
Come lay your weakness down on the floor in the backseat.
Tap into the movement, tap into the stillness. What's stabilizing so that you can move?
Woo!
2 more. Beautiful. Feet come down. Walk your feet a little bit away from you, or slide your feet a little bit away from you, so that you're digging your heels in. We're gonna keep these weights in your hands. Your knees are longer though, so your legs are pretty long here, toes to the sky. Push down, lift your hips up, so you're in a really long bridge. Hug your shoulders toward your hips. Inhale, reach overhead. Exhale, hug the elbows in toward the ribcage. Your hips are up the whole time. If any piece of this doesn't work, consider just doing one piece. Maybe just the pullover, maybe just the bridge. And we're just holding this bridge. So nice, strong, isometric in that lower body. Belly drawing in enough so that you feel stable here. Not so much that you cannot breathe. Last 2. Last 1. Beautiful. Weights come down, please. Slide your feet in a little closer and then bring those weights back to your hips. Bridge up, drop down. So just these nice little hip thrusts, dynamic bridge, doesn't matter what you call them, it's the same thing. Feel your feet on the floor. Your feet can be as wide as they need to so that you feel stable and that you actually can access your glutes. Yes. Yeah, 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 yeah. Hold it up, we pulse it right here. Take it up. Small, small, small. Breathe. Don't tune it out. Tune in. Feel what you feel. Embrace it. 8, 7, three, two, one. So good. Weights down for good. Weights are down for good. If you have a mini ball, grab it. If you don't have it, you're fine without. Come onto your forearms behind you like this. The ball gives you like a little extra stability and it gives you something to pull back into. So that the sense of drawing the ribs back, drawing the belly back, like you want to squish the ball. Yep, good. Right leg lifts up. Open up your chest. We're extending, single leg stretch, draw in. Open up your chest. Can you create a little crunch here without using the upper body? Like lower body like pulls in. You shouldn't say lower body, lower belly. But the lower body's creating it, is what I'm saying.
We love you very much.
One more. Take that leg out straight. Hold it. If you want to do a little turnout here, it's fine. If you like your hip in neutral, keep the thigh bone nice and square, the foot nice and square. We're going to lift and lower. Don't stop.
Thank you, guys. Take care of each other. Peace.
And then put that right foot down flat. Ah. Left leg extends out. Open up your chest. Draw the knee in. Extend. I neglected to say this on the first side, because I do that often. Push your right foot down. Stabilize. I hope that starts to become habit. I have a feeling it probably is with you. But if it's not moving, it's stabilizing. Nothing in our body is superfluous. Like it all matters. So even if it's not moving, it matters. It's stabilizing. I love this song. This is one of the songs I put on in the car and I like blast it. Sounds good loud. Four, three, two, hold it out. Drop, lift. I'm lifting to about the height of my other knee. So it's not super high. Check in with your collarbones, check in with your posture. Front ribs draw back, belly pulls back. Whew. Yes, there's a lot of hip flexor here. If you're feeling that, that's not wrong. Hip flexors are like the core of your core. Four, three, two, one. Beautiful. Ball out. Lie down. I took out my mini bands and I don't think we're going to use them today. I don't think we're going to use them today. Isn't that rare? Curl your shoulders up. Inhale, exhale. Try to keep the shoulders up. If you need support for your head, one or both arms back. Hold this one up, hold it up. We're gonna go side to side. Boom, boom. Come through center, release it down. Soles of the feet come together. Baddha Konasana. Good. Stay here or push the pinky edge of your feet down and bridge your hips up. Hold it, hold it, hold it, hold it. Flip onto your bellies. Home stretch, y'all. We always have to get some posterior core in. Have to. In this one, hand stack,
forehead down, opposition, legs like you're swimming.
Focus on lengthening those legs out. How long can you make them? I don't care how high the leg comes.
It's control.
And really getting that sense of hip extension.
Good, now stay here or
pull the elbows in a little bit and then press to lift up. This is gonna limit the hip movement. And I want it smaller, I want it lesser. So you're not cranking the back. Now pull the elbows back, lift the heart through. 4, 3, 2, legs down. Release the arms to the side. Mm-hmm. Lengthen out your low back. Lengthen out your tailbone. Send your tailbone for your heels. Little lift. Lift. Now take all this height. We're going to take it away. You're just going to hover your face from the floor. Reach overhead. Squeeze back. Keep those arms up. Feet are down. Press the tops of your feet down. Four more, come on. 4, 3. Hold it back. Drop your face a little lower. Lift the elbows a little higher. Pull the chest open. Feet float up. We're just hovering off the ground with the torso, like the chest, the face, the feet, not super high. Hollow the belly a little bit more. Shorten from your belly button to your pubic bone. Sternum to belly button shortens. Hold it, hold it. 4, 3, 2, child's pose, press it back. Amazing.
Roll up into cat's pose. Pull through, get a nice stretch here.
It's not a cobra, it's just a stretch. Press it back, child's pose.
Round up through cat's pose, tuck your toes, down dog. Walk your hands and your feet together.
Rise up with an inhale. With your exhale, draw your hands into your heart. You are done and you are also amazing. Excellent work.